smoking. Midget attitude and little midget on the side said, "Man, that's a bad motherfucker over there." And she hugged another midget. She was looking. She checked me out. I never had a midget look at me like this. And she walked up to me. I was with a girl, and the midget said, "Is she with you?" And I said, "Yes." And she can't do half the things I do to you. She walked her little midget ass. Then the brain started going. Fuck that midget. Because your imagination starts going. You start, thinking all that. Midget is light. You think about all the shit you can do with a midget. You can picture the midget on your dick jumping up and down. Throw the midget up in the air. The bed up against the wall. And have your friend toss her across the room on my dick. The midget got up to go to the bathroom, and he laid in the bed, see a little naked motherfucker. "I'll be right back." And my lucky shit, luck I was having that shit, the midget would have got pregnant. That would have been all I needed and shit. Front page of the Inquirer and shit. Eddie Murphy gets midget pregnant. That's just true, isn't it? Inquiring minds want to know. Have a picture of a motherfucking midget, little big head midget with a big, little big head midget baby come out and be a midget, and it be my kid, and I have a little midget kid. Yeah, throw a monkey wrench and all this cool shit I be trying to. Yeah, I'm cool lad, you know. Yeah, what about that little big head midget son? Excuse me, y'all. When they give a little midget kid a midget name, named Little Tip Tip.
Baby Tip Tip. Tip Tip Murphy.
Well, you know, I couldn't have no relationship with no. Hey, well, you know, it's my child, so I got to do the right thing. I ain't gonna be walking through Central Park with no midgets. Hey, well, you know, yeah, I got my responsibility. Yeah, this Murphy coming to the hospital. This is my lady. Little Miss Andrew. And midgets are people too, they got egos, so I would have this little midget woman mad at me. And she would turn into a fatal attraction midget. Stand in front of my house all night long and she goes,
"I ain't even today, come outside. Maybe you can just tell me mama be out of here. So we gonna take care of him, so he gonna talk to me. He gonna talk to me with that pussy. Don't you know what I was talking to you like I'm a motherfucking fool. I'm a human being. What? Shit, you better tell Eddie Murphy to get it.
Old and be mad, little son have an attitude and shit.
Two
articles
and... Yeah, well, I just want him to acknowledge me and my mom. Because I'm definitely his child. You know, he think he could just step over us, but they like that. Fuck that, I'm a man. I'm a motherfucking man. And how you fuck, no, fuck the big time for this deal. Everybody walk up and say, "You know, you look just like a little tiny Eddie Murphy."
I was talking to my friend the other day. I have this friend. You ever have one of those friends? You ever have a friend who's just an idiot? Well, this friend of mine, he's always talking in cliches. That's what I hate about him. He just talks in cliches, and he doesn't even say one that matches to what I was saying, you know? Like, he's just got one ready for when it's his turn to talk. You know, whatever I say, I'll be like, "Oh, I locked my keys in my car." And he's like, "Yeah, well, don't shit where you eat." What the fuck does that mean? Like, "Oh, I forgot my sister's birthday." "Yeah, well, payback's a bitch." I like those people that use old sayings, but they don't know how they end, so they just trail off. You know, people are like, "Yeah, well, a bird in a hand." You know what I'm saying? Well, I don't think you know what you're saying. A bird in a hand what, you idiot? You know what I do? I just make up my own endings, because nobody gives a shit. Nobody's listening to you. I just go, bird in a hand is like a man in the sand. You know what I mean? When in Rome, you gotta grab the hand of a badger's dad. That's what I always say. Yep. Talking to my this guy Jerry that I know, and he's one of these guys. You know those people who they sound like they're happy for you, but they sound like they're in pain also. You know people that talk like that. He's like, "Hey, what's going on?" And I go, "Well, my sister is getting married." "Oh, that's wonderful. Oh, that's terrific. Yeah, and I think we're going to have a baby. Oh, my God. God bless you. Wow. Thanks, pal.
Oh, I know what I'm talking about. I just had a kid about 10 months ago. I had a daughter. I had a little girl. Pretty little kid. I went in and watched the kid come out. You know, because somebody told me, "Oh, it's beautiful, and you should watch the experience of it." That's some nasty shit. You know, there's nothing nicer than that. There's nothing beautiful, and oh, and you feel the whole, it's so beautiful. It's just a nasty experience. You go in there and see it. Because a lot of shit that's happening there that just fuck with your brain. Like, you go in there rational, then there's some irrational things happening in there. Because you go in there and think, "Okay, I'm going to watch this bird, and it's going to be cool." You go in the room, and the first thing you see is a pussy. Not quite looking like a pussy. It kind of looks like a pussy. It looked more like a big hairy catches me. "This kid's baby, where's the pussy?" He said, "That's the pussy there." I said, no, that's a catches me with the head. That's the pussy. And then you see it, and then there's a head. And when you see a head in the pussy, you just fucked up with that. You can't think anymore. You say, "The head in that pussy." And I said, "Yes, that's your daughter's head. See, the baby's head is there." And then and you start putting his fingers in. And you said, "Yeah, I see the head in the pussy, but should the head be in there?" Yes, it's going to come out, and they're pushing this baby out, and they push it out. And you see this shit come out, and you expect like a little Gerber baby. Nasty looking. I was like, "Can we take the blood test now?" And my family has like broad noses and shit, so when my daughter came out, she had this nose on her. And I was like, "Is it a boy or a girl?" The doctor said, "Right now it's just nostrils. I don't know what that is." Then afterwards, the pussy was ruined. It didn't look like a pussy no more. Because it was open like this. Then it stayed open after the baby came out. For 15 minutes. Didn't even look like an old hat or some shit. Like the pussy just like this. And everybody in the room was crying. The baby was crying. And the girl was crying, "Oh, my baby." And I was crying, "Oh, no, your pussy." You know, perspective though, when you look at women, a whole new respect, you get a whole different thing. You say, "Hey, because I know guys, you think about he couldn't put no person out your dick." A whole person come out your dick, that would make a woman push a whole person out of them. I have a lot of respect, you know, for Michael Jackson's mother, because a whole band came out of her.
This is a true story. I know I say a lot of stories are true, and you know, there's a lot of stories that are bullshit. You know, like those urban myths. You know those stories that people swear are true, but you know that they're bullshit. You know, like everybody has that story, like the guy who goes on a date with a girl, and you know, he sleeps with her, and he wakes up, and when he wakes up, she's at the foot of the bed, and she's going, "La la 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 la." And you know it's bullshit, but he's like, "No, it happened to me," and you're like, "Fuck you." But anyway, this story is true. So I called a friend of mine the other day. You ever make a phone call and you get the wrong number and the person that answers can't believe that you would ever get a wrong number? You ever get someone who doesn't take it in stride? I got this lady once. I was like, "Hi, is Tony there?" She's like, "Who? Tony. I don't know a Tony. How did you get this number? What do you want from me?" I guess it was the first time her phone rang in like 20 years or something. She hung up, so I just kept pressing redial. "Put Tony on her, I'll fucking kill you." I used to like when my phone rang. Now it's always some idiot calling me. AT&T calls me every day.
Hi, it's AT&T. You're calling. If you want to switch to AT&T, it's good service because you call your friend on the phone. They can be in another part of the area. And you call them. And you don't have to yell or anything. You're just right there. So what do you think? Would you like to switch? It only costs some money. Would you like to switch for the AT&T? And I'm like, no, I already have AT&T. I have it already. Why are you calling me?
Well, still, you want some more? Because it's good. Get some more AT&T. It's better than the other ones.
I know, I have it! Stop fucking calling me! Dirty South. Uh-huh. Ain't got really feel me. Feel us. West Coast, them fellas. West Coast, them. Say what? Dirty South. Here we go.
I was at church one time, you got young folk going to church, they don't know, they ain't been in a while, they don't know what to do. I was at the church one time, being a little girl, you know, she young, she ain't know what's going on. People in church shouting, how about somebody, she was looking around, she felt under pressure to do something, and she just, well, I'm gonna miss everybody, and I'm gonna miss everybody, and miss my Uncle Charles, Lord, like, did you just bone thugs at church? That is unacceptable. You can get off the chain sometimes. I visited the church one time, and the preacher cussed at church. And he didn't even know he had cursed. That's what the thing was. He just kept on preaching. I'm like, damn, y'all know he just cursed, you know? And he couldn't blame him, no, because he didn't know he had cursed. He was talking about the crucifixion of Christ and got a little wound up. And didn't know he had cursed. He was into it. He was like, you know, and first they nailed the cross to his hands, and then they put the cross on his back and made him walk for miles with the cross on his back after he had died for their sins. And after all that, you know the motherfucker told Jesus. Did you hear it? Did you hear what he just said? Why ain't nobody saying that? He just... And he didn't know he said it because he didn't ever stop. He didn't ever apologize for it or nothing. He just kept on preaching. So now I'm sitting in my pew, got to deal with that. And after a while, I start thinking about it, and I'm like, you know what? The motherfucker was wrong for doing that to Jesus. I wish I was there back then. I would have said it off. Music has changed, man. You don't buy no album no more. You want to get the real reality of somebody, like your kids or something, or your wife, you want to know what they really about, pick up their iPod. That way you'll know what somebody really into. You can just tell by the music on their iPod. I got a little daughter, she just turned 19. I got a little daughter, I picked up an iPod, a shuffle. Just shuffle around, see what was on there, you know. I mean, I picked it up and the first song came on and I was like, okay. She go to school with white kids, okay, I just had a little Fergie on there, you know. You just never know what you gotta do. Turn that off. I was like, okay. I wasn't sure, then I hit it one more time just to make sure everything cool, and then I hit that one, and this one came. Yeah, we do go to church. I'm trying to take that. I was like, okay, that's good. So I put it down at that point, and I thought I was cool. I put it down, and I was going on about my business, and I picked it up one more time because I wasn't sure. And I picked it up one more time, and this shit came on, and I was like, whoa.
All you ladies pop your pussy like this. Shake your body, don't stop, don't miss, just do it, do it.
Couldn't believe it.
Do it, do it.
Yeah, and we had choir practice, let you know everybody up in the